All right, Ninja Nerds, today we're gonna go into the anatomy of the skull, all right?
So if you look right here, there's this actual suture running right here. This suture is called the frontal or the coronal suture. It's basically separating the frontal bone from the two parietal bones here, okay? Then we have this suture running right here, right down the middle. This is called the mid-sagittal suture, or you can actually just call it the sagittal suture. So here's our sagittal suture, and it's separating the two parietal bones here. I'm gonna flip it over here. And if you look over here, we're going to have this other suture running right here in the back. This is called the lambdoid suture right here. This is what basically separates the parietal bones from the occipital bone. Then if we come over here on the other side, if you look here, let me fix this for you guys. This right here is going to be called the squamous suture. So this is our squamous suture right here, separating the parietal bone from the temporal bones. All right, so now that we covered out those sutures, those are going to kind of help us to differentiate what's separating the parietal bones from some of these bones that we talked about. Let's go ahead and talk about the frontal bone. So here is our frontal bone right here. So if we look at the frontal bone, there's a couple different structures I want to talk about. If you know these guys right here, these are your orbits, all right? So that's what holds the actual eye, right? Then if I kind of like scrape the surface here, right above the orbit, scrape that surface, that's called the supraorbital margins, right? So I'm scraping the surface here as a supraorbital margin. If you look, it's right here on this part here, there's like a little notch, that's called the supraorbital notch or foramen, okay? Then if I kind of like look here, there's these lumpy parts here of the frontal bone. There's hollow cavities behind this area here. It's called the frontal sinus. And the frontal sinuses, both on both sides here, they're going to be paranasal sinuses, which means that they drain into the nasal cavity. All right. Then if you look right here, just this surface right here, this is called the glabella. Okay, so we got the glabella, supraorbital margins, supraorbital notch, orbits, and then we got the frontal sinuses. Inside the skull, we're gonna have this big like little fossa, this divot. And this divot right here is called the anterior cranial fossa. All right, so that covers the frontal bone. So within the frontal bone, we've already covered those structures. Now let's go ahead and move over and let's go look at the occipital bone. So I'm gonna put this cap back on here, okay? So if I look here on the occipital bone, there's this structure right here. If you look here, it's kind of like a nice big bump. It's called the external occipital protuberance. So this nice big bump right here is called the external occipital protuberance. Now, I'm gonna come in here, there's these little lines right above the external occipital protuberance moving laterally from that point. This is called the superior nuchal line, all right, the superior nuchal line. These nice little articulating surfaces here are called the occipital condyles, called the occipital condyles. So they articulate with the articulating surfaces of atlas. Now, what I'm gonna do is there's a nice little hole here I'm gonna show you. If you look there, and I'm gonna kinda show it like that. That right there is gonna be called the hypoglossal canal, where that pipe cleaner is going. So the pipe cleaner that's running right through that hole is gonna be called the hypoglossal canal. It's where the hypoglossal nerve runs through. All right, if you look here, there's going to be like a little divot here, okay? This is called the condylar fossa. This is called the condylar fossa right there. It's just a little divot right there. Then there's a little hole, the little hole called the condylar canal. Okay, it's called the condylar canal right in there. All right, now that we covered that, those bases of the occipital bone, let's go ahead and move her over here into the temporal bone. So if you remember, temporal bone has that squamous suture right there, right? Now, this breast-like process is gonna be called the mastoid process. It's the mastoid process. And inside the mastoid process, you're gonna have a hollow cavity, which accumulates the mucus, and that's gonna be, it's hollow, you know, hollow cavity. It's going to be called the mastoid sinus. Then, and this is not paranasal, so it doesn't drain into the nasal cavity. This right here, this little hole here, that's your external acoustic or your auditory meatus, right? So the external acoustic meatus, right? That guy right there. Now I'm going to flip it up a little bit. If you look over here, I got this little like stylus looking thing. It looks like kind of like a little point. That's called the styloid process right there. It's called the styloid process. Then there's a hole that I'm gonna kind of poke in here, right in between these two, if you look. This is the mastoid process, that's your styloid process, the hole right between these guys, which is called the stylomastoid foramen, where the facial nerve runs out through, okay? Now, a couple other things I wanna talk about before we move on. This little process coming off the temporal bone is going to be called the zygomatic process of the temporal bone. Over here, we got the zygomatic bone, right there, right? So here's our zygomatic bone. there's a process that comes off of the zygomatic bone, and that's called the temporal process. So if you look at it, we have the temporal process of the zygomatic bone, and the zygomatic process of the temporal bone, and they form the zygomatic arch, right? And then one more thing, I'm gonna pull this mandible out. If you look, this little jelly covered thing right here, this is actually called the actual temporal fossa, or the mandibular fossa, right? So this is where the actual mandibular condyles, they stick into the mandibular fossa right there, and they form the TMJ joint, the temporal mandibular joint, right? So here we got in there, again, you got that mandibular fossa, right? All right, so that covers that part for the temporal bone. Now, what I wanna do is, I wanna go ahead and look inside the skull. So if you look here, this guy right here, we're gonna look at the ethmoid bone right here. This guy right here is called the crista galli of the ethmoid bone. So it's one of these little shark fin-like structures that pop out up, you know, in the cranial cavity. So this is called the crista galli. There's a plate right here where I'm poking, right there. And that's where the olfactory foramina, which are these little holes where the olfactory nerves run up through. This plate, which has those olfactory foramina on them, is going to be called the cribriform plate, right? And again, there's little olfactory foramina where the olfactory nerves run up through. Okay, and again, we already told you that this was the anterior cranial fossa. Now, if you look here, there's these little fang-like things right there, right? These little fang-like structures are going to be called the anterior clinoid processes. Anterior clinoid processes, right? And then if you look right here, I'm going to make a circle here. I'm going to make a whole circle. This whole circle that I'm making is going to be making up what's called the sella-tursica of the sphenoid bone. The sella-tursica means Turkish saddle. So if you look here where like someone would put their butt inside the saddle, this is called the hypophyseal fossa. That's where the pituitary gland sits. Then you actually have what's called the dorsum sellae, which is here in the back. And then you got the tuberculum sellae, which is here in the front. And then right here, we have this wing here. It's kind of like the lesser wing. It's the small one, right? So this right here going from here to here that I'm kind of scraping over, this is the lesser wing of the sphenoid bone. We'll show you in another video about the sphenoid bone individually. But this right here coming out from this side and this side here, this is the greater wing. So greater wing here, greater wing there, right? Then if you look here, I'm going to poke a hole right through here. I'm actually going to use a pipe cleaner. I put a hole right through there. That is actually called the optic canal. I'll show you so from the front. So there's going to be called the optic canal. And that is where the optic nerve, cranial nerve 1, I'm sorry, cranial nerve 2 runs through. Sorry about that. This one is actually going to be called the superior orbital fissure, all right? And it's better seen in the orbit, so I'm going to flip it around here so you can see it there. So there is actually going to be the superior orbital fissure, all right? That's the superior orbital fissure. A lot of nerves run through that hole, right? Now, we're going to cover a couple more foramen here. So if you look here, I'm going to try to angle this right here. There's a hole right here. This is called the foramen rotundum, all right? It's called the foramen rotundum. Then I'm going to go down a little bit more. There's another one. It's a little more oval shaped. This one is called the foramen ovale. Then I'm going to move it over here a little bit more laterally. It's right next to the foramen ovale. It's called the foramen spinosum. Okay. This one's actually another one over here. You can see the foramen spinosum. It's a little bit better right there. Okay. So that's the foramen spinosum. Right here, there's another hole that runs through here. That's actually called the foramen lacerum. It's the foramen lacerum right there. Then there's another hole, and I'm going to kind of turn it up so you guys can see it. It's called the carotid canal. It's where the internal carotid artery runs through. So you've got the carotid canal right here. And all this region right here, it's kind of like this hill region. It's called the petrous region of the temporal bone. On the back side here, we got the internal acoustic or auditory meatus. So right here, we got the internal acoustic or auditory meatus right there. Then, if I work right here, this guy right there is actually called the jugular foramen. All right, so that's our jugular foramen. And then this one is obviously the foramen magnum, where the spinal cord, the brainstem and the spinal cord run out, right? All right. Then if I'm gonna scoop all these guys out, so let's pretend I take an ice cream scoop again. So I scoop out this part here, scoop out this part here. This is called the middle cranial fossa. Just like this one was the anterior cranial fossa, this is the middle cranial fossa. And this whole thing back here is the posterior cranial fossa. All right? So that pretty much covers the structures that we're gonna talk about inside the skull. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna focus on some of these bones over here. So if you look here, these are our nasal bones. We have two of them over there. We already showed you a little bit of the orbit, but I wanna show you two more things in the orbit. So in the orbit, there is another slit-like structure because we had the superior orbital fissure. There's one that's actually going to be a little bit lower, and that's called the inferior orbital fissure. Okay. Okay, we got the superior orbital fissure, and then we got the inferior orbital fissure, right? Then another structure I want to show you is this one right here. All right, and this is actually going to be called the lacrimal fossa. All right, so that's where the nasal lacrimal duct that's actually going to kind of move through that area. All right, so that's the lacrimal fossa. All right, then what I want to do is, if you look here, there's a hole right underneath the foramen. It's called the infraorbital foramen right there. So infraorbital foramen. All right, then we're going to kind of look at the nasal cavity a little bit. So let me get here inside the nasal cavity. So right here, actually, if you kind of look at this, this is the maxillary bone right here. So all this right here is the maxillary bone. These are the nasal bones, but this area right here is going to be the maxillary bone. So if you look here, there's kind of like this little spiny part that's popping out there. I don't know if you guys can see that. It's called the anterior nasal spine. Okay. There's this big bone, though. It's its own bone, and it's running all the way back here inside the nasal cavity. This one right here, so it's called the vomer bone. Okay, the vomer bone. So it helps to be able to make up the nasal septum. I'm going to kind of flip it up here. And right in here, if you see this guy right there, that's actually called the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid bone. Now, a little bit laterally to it, you might not be able to see it that well, but these guys right here laterally to it, this right here is actually going to be called the middle nasal concha. And this one over here on the other side is the middle nasal concha. This guy right here is called the inferior nasal concha. And inferior nasal concha right there too. Okay, so that kind of covers some of the structures inside of the nasal cavity. All right, now if we come down here and we look at the maxillary region, so this is going to be kind of like the alveolar processes, and then you got the alveolar margin right here where the teeth are. Now the teeth sit in a little cavity called the gum fosses. It forms the gum fosses joint, but the little alveolus is where the teeth actually sit in. All right, we'll get into teeth anatomy specifically later. All right, so again, that's going to cover that. Now, I'm going to move down here to the mandible. So look at the mandible here. We got this part of the mandible right here where it looks like it's making like a little circle right here, right? This is called the mandibular notch. It's called the mandibular notch right there. And then this right here is going to be called the coronoid process of the mandible. So this is the coronoid process. Then if you look here, the part that's articulating with that mandibular fossa, this is called the mandibular condyles. So these guys right here are called the mandibular condyles, okay? Now, if I make kind of like a square here, this is called the ramus, so it's the ramus of the mandible. Then if I squeeze this thick part, this is where the bone's the thickest. So this is the body of the mandible, this part right here, this is the body of the mandible. All right? Yeah, sorry for my thumb, guys. And then here is going to be the mental foramen. All right, so here's the mental foramen. So you got the body of the mandible, you got the mental foramen, then you got the mandibular symphysis right here. Okay? So you got the mandibular symphysis. Then, if I come over and I actually try to get inside, I'm going to flip this around here a little bit so we can see it. So inside here, we're actually going to have the mandibular foramina. So the mandibular foramina. So here's the mandibular foramina right here, these guys. All right, so that covers these parts. Now we're going to kind of flip it under here and look at a couple structures inside here. So if you look here, in the front, we've got the maxillary bone here in the front. All right, so now if you look here, we got this little hole right there. This right here, it's called the incisive fossa. So that's right there, it's called the incisive fossa. Then we got over here, we still got the palatine process. All this stuff right here is all the palatine process of the maxillary bone. Don't confuse that with this part right here. This is actually the palatine bone. So it's the horizontal plate of the palatine bone, and then moving here on the sides is the vertical plate, or the perpendicular plate of the palatine bone. All right? Oh, and then in these guys right here that look like little legs, these guys are actually called the pterygoid processes of the sphenoid bone. All right, that pretty much covers all the structures of the skull.